Good morning. In my last session, I have discussed about meiosis 1. Meiosis is a cell division which has taken place in the sex cells or gametes. It undergoes two divisions, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. And meiosis 1 is called heterotypic division because the daughter cells are not like a parents, so it is called as heterotypic division. And it has four phases: prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1. And this prophase 1 further divided into 5 substages: leptotene, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene and diakinesis. And we have seen about the changes which has taken place during each type of subdivisions. And at the end of telophase stage, the two daughter cells are formed, two daughter nuclei are formed, and followed the nuclear division, cytoplasm divide and form two daughter cells, right? Okay, now I am going to see about the homotypic division. Actually, this is called meiotic 2 also. Okay, why it is called homotypic division? The daughter cells have the same number of chromosome as like their parent. Okay, that is at the end of meiotic 1, two daughter cells are formed with haploid set of chromosome. These two daughter cells enter into another cell division, homotypic or meiotic cell division 2. So here the parent cells have haploid number of chromosome and undergo cell division as like a previous type of cell division with the four substages: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, and finally form four daughter cells. Okay, so at the end of meiotic cell division, four daughter cells are formed. So let's enter into the text, children. Homotypic division. In this division, the two haploid cells formed during first meiotic division divide into four haploid cells. The daughter cells are similar to parent cell in the chromosome number. It is consist of five stages: prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, telophase 2 and cytokinesis 2. Then let's see what has taken place in prophase 2. In prophase 2 stage, as like the centriole divides into two, each one moves to opposite poles. Okay, so first, as like other type of cell division, in prophase 1, the centrioles are divided into two and moves to opposite poles, and asters and spindle fibers appear. And next, what happened? Nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear. This is usual changes taken place in each prophase stage of cell division, whether it may be mitosis or meiosis 1 or meiosis 2. Three constant changes has taken place in the prophase stage. First one, the spindle fibers divide, moves towards opposite pole and form spindle apparatus. Okay, and second change, nuclear membrane disappear, and third change, nucleolus disappear. These are the three constant changes has taken place in prophase 1. Okay, and metaphase 2, the chromosome sets arranged on the equator, two chromatids are separated. Okay, during the metaphase stage, the irregularly arranged chromosomes in the nucleus have arranged in regular form in the center of the cell, that is equator of the cell, and form a metaphase plate. Okay, and during this type, two chromatids are separated from each other. You know, children, each chromosome has a centromere in the center and two arms on the opposite sides. These two arms are called chromatids. So during metaphase stage, these chromatids are separated from each other. So this is what the changes has taken place during the metaphase 2. And anaphase 2, the separated chromatids become daughter chromosomes and move to the opposite side. Okay, during anaphase stage, the separated chromatids in the metaphase stage moves towards the opposite pole and behave as daughter chromosomes. Okay, and telophase 2, the daughter chromosomes are centered, the nuclear membrane and the nucleolus appear. Okay, once the daughter chromosomes moves towards the opposite pole and reach the center in the pole and form a nuclear membrane and a nucleolus. Okay children, see children, this is what it is, opposite changes has taken place when compared to prophase. During prophase, nuclear membrane disappear. During telophase stage, nuclear membrane reappear. During prophase stage, nucleolus disappear. Here in telophase, nucleolus reappear. Okay, so there is an opposite changes has taken place during these two phases of the mitosis and meiosis. And next one is cytokinesis 2. Okay, at the end of telophase, the two nucleus are formed in the opposite pole. Followed that, the cytoplasm divide and form two daughter cells. Okay, cytokinesis, two cells are formed from each haploid daughter cells, resulting in the formation of four cells with haploid number of chromosomes. Okay, so that's all about meiosis children, and let's enter into the significance of meiosis. Okay, the constant, what are the significance of meiosis? The constant number of chromosome in a given species is maintained by meiotic division. You know children, in each species of an organism have a constant number of chromosome. You know very well that. Okay, say for example human. In human, in each and every cell, they are having only 46 chromosome, not more than that or less than that. If whomever it may be, okay, whomever it may be in the world, in his and her body cell consists of 46 chromosome only, not more than that or less than that. Okay, so to maintain this constant number of chromosome, meiotic division is essential. Why? Because of the meiotic division only, the gametes are produced as half the set. Okay, that is in haploid nature. When the gametes are fused together form, it retain the original number of chromosome, that is diploid number. Okay children, so that's what the first significance. Okay, next in the table it's given the difference between mitosis and meiosis. So where the first point occurs in somatic cell and in meiosis occurs in reproductive cell. So very beginning itself I said children, mitosis has taken place in the somatic cells or body cells, but the meiotic cell division takes place only in the sex cells or gametes. Okay, and involved in growth and occurs continuously throughout the life. The mitosis cell division involved in the growth of an organism and occurs continuously throughout the life, but this meiotic cell division involved in gamete formation only during the reproductive age only. Okay, so in mitosis that cell division occurs during the growth. Okay, so you know children, growth has taken place throughout the life, so mitotic cell division also taken place throughout the life, but meiotic cell division, it has taken place only reproductively age, that is from puberty to menopause. Up to this period only the meiotic cell division will be taken place, that is up to which period the gametes are produced, up to that period only meiotic cell division can be taken place. After that it will not be taken place. Okay, and consist of single division. Mitosis undergo only one division, but meiosis is not like that. It undergo two division, one is meiotic one, another one is meiotic two. And fourth point, two diploid daughter cells are formed. At the end of mitosis, two diploid daughter cells are formed, but at the end of meiosis, four haploid daughter cells are formed. Then fifth point, the chromosome number in the daughter cell is similar to that of the parent cell, that is diploid in nature. Yes, as I said, the number of chromosome in the daughter cell is exactly like the parent cell. But in meiosis, the number of chromosome in the daughter cell is just half of the parent cell only. It is not like the parent number of chromosome. And the last point, identical daughter cells are formed. Here, daughter cells are not similar to the parent cell and are randomly assorted.
So here identical, the daughter cells are produced or identical to parent, but here daughter cells are not similar to the parent cell and are randomly asserted. Okay children, this lesson we have completed, and I'll continue the next class with the next chapter. So the homework for you, today's homework: significance of meiosis and difference between mitosis and meiosis. These two only homework for you children. Complete it and send it to me. And many of you still did not submit your classwork note. Complete it and submit it soon. And I'll meet you in my next session. Bye.